This video will cover the network editor within Houdini. We'll start by dropping a grid down and applying a mountain deformer. Change the height value to 0.5, and let's turn off the ortho grid. Everything you create in Houdini becomes a node. Let's have a look at the nodes we've made. Hit the L key to lay out the nodes. Here you can see a node for the grid and another for the mountain node. Each node has a base construction, which consists of flags, inputs, and outputs. Node names are indicated on the right side of a node. The display flag located here is used to indicate visibility on an object, which is set to blue when turned on. Now we can see the grid as a shaded object, while the mountain is in wireframe because that node is selected. Clicking on nodes will allow you to go back in the network to see what the geometry looked like earlier in the creation process. Clicking on the display flag of the mountain node will restore visibility of it in the viewport, but because we still have the grid selected, we can still edit it. We will turn on the template flag for the grid node so that it will remain visible in the viewport even though the node isn't selected. For example, you could use it for snapping geometry too. Now we're going to click on the mountain node and continue making some edits. Hit the 4 key to select faces and we'll apply a poly extrude on them. And now let's pull out the faces and we'll change key points shared to no, and we'll change the value on inset. We can click on the bypass flag to ignore the effect of that node. Or we can grab the mountain node and jiggle it to pull it out of the network because wiring and unwiring nodes in Houdini is non-destructive, so that gives you room to explore as you work. And now we can pop it back in by dropping it between the two nodes. We can also right mouse button click on the wire here and disconnect it. You'll notice our extrude node has some red arrow lines across. That is because it doesn't have any geometry to work with. We'll rewire the two simply by clicking on the output of the mountain node and connecting it to the input of the poly extrude node. Hit the L key to organize your nodes. Now we're going to look at some ways to organize and lay out nodes in the network editor. Up here, you'll find a number of options to lay out your nodes with. Align vertical or horizontal edges, distribute horizontally, and others. You can also turn on the grid and snap your nodes to arrange them in this way. And now we can turn the grid off. And we'll make a network box from these two nodes. Let's give it a name, and we'll also include a little sticky note with a short description inside. We can also change the color of the node and network box. And now we can double-click to collapse the network box with the two nodes and sticky note inside.